The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi folks, Basil Chapman. This is the Wednesday, July the 17th edition, and we're looking at the Dow of 263 points at 34,773. And this is where I have to give a huge mea culpa to my subscribers. I don't know how this happened. When I did my analysis on Monday night, I said, oh, you know what? This is something completely new. We haven't had this kind of scenario in a long time. Actually, not quite the same way in recent memory, as far as I'm concerned, where we get off a high, we get a major thrust to the downside, and the VIX index suddenly spikes higher. And you know, my rule of thumb is that if off a high, if very quickly you're starting to see the VIX index rally as sharp as it would if it was a couple of days of real bad news, but there isn't really an overarching bad news event. You remember, I'll just do this real quickly here. I hope I've got it right there. Remember, I've said since May, the Dow has been in this, let me squeeze. You, first of all, look at this rectangle formation right here. Look at that high. That's the May the 10th high of the Dow. And look at this. I'll squeeze it close right here. This is the Dow Dark News Cloud Covers Chapman Wave Methodology. And I've said for a long time, since May, I said, is this a, do we have, there isn't an overreaching or overarching yields or China or impeachment or whatever it is. We don't have anything in the market that says, or oil, we just don't have anything that is a singular force that maybe has a couple of derivatives, but it's a singular force that is just saying to the market, oh my goodness, this is really bad news. And the market takes it as bad news. So this is something very different. So these sudden plunges to the downside have been met with buying. So what I said to subscribers, and I can't believe I didn't just go over it before I sent out my newsletter yesterday morning, is I said right here on Wednesday, today's Wednesday. Yeah, so on Tuesday I said for the diamonds, because we are long the diamonds, we are long from the March 23rd low, we started buying the Dow on the day of the low with options of March 23rd last year. And then a week later, we bought the diamonds, which we still have. We've taken off some, but we really have the core position. But I've prided myself in being able to get many of these sharp declines, these plunges, and we've rallied. We've had some really nice trades to the upside. And I thought we did that yesterday because I said, start along under, and then I forgot to put the actual price. And with my rule of thumb in the trader's corner is that you've got to have the numbers. You always have to have the stop in place before you get the position. That's the way we do it. Yes, we've got stopped out of a couple of positions in the last couple of days of fabulous stocks with really nice moves that they stopped us out with a small loss, and then they just rallied back sharply yesterday and today. What can I say? But this was the one that I thought we had. And I said, so long. And then I said, try for a bounce. But I forgot to specify the entry price. Now, some of my subscribers have been with me a long time, know exactly what I'm, when I say buy it, it means I have a conviction. So they bought it on the open or just before, and they're long. But officially, we're not in it. Unfortunately, we would have been. And I didn't see the questions from subscribers that came in because I was really busy and I never got onto the den. I didn't go into the den until just before my show. So I missed questions that I had that I saw much later in the day saying, what was the entry price for the diamonds? Oh, I'm so sorry. And we would have had such a good move. It went from an entry point of about 340.30.29 or something like that. And the diamonds are trading right now at 347. We were in another one of those that we just picked off the bottom and had a really nice entry. And unfortunately, I had this, we've still got this. We bought the one-to-one short And I didn't expect in one day we would go all the way to 34,600. 34,620 is where I thought the big resistance would be. So I said to buy the DOG. So we have that now. What can I say? It's down a little bit. It's not a big deal. But can't believe it. Sorry, subscribers. Well, we've got others that are doing very well. But apologies are being thrown out here effusively, because that was really just a very I didn't read. If I'd read it, we would have got in. We had it because I was going to give it a little room. What can I say? Spilt milk. We'll make it up. The S&P right now is, I just typed in the wrong thing. The S&P is, there it is. So the S&P is rallying nicely up 26 at 4349.08. If it gets to 4393.69, this week it extends leg D in the weekly chart. Otherwise, we'll be making a peak D, but this is still leg B in the monthly chart. Unbelievable action. And what can I say? It should still make a peak B with a lower high bar for a month and then go to a new high. So I still think the S&P in 2021 is going to go quite a lot higher. Let's go to the QQQ. And, of course, that means all the indexes should. So we've got the QQQ up 47 cents, up 13.13%, 359.29. It's not bad, but it hasn't even taken out yesterday's high. I think that's the sector that's starting to stall just a little bit here, just for the moment. Peak D in the weekly chart. I'm not sure it's going to make a leg extension of the leg D. This we'll see. And a leg G/C in the monthly chart, I think, is C. And now let's go to the IWM, which we are also long. Like we're long the Dow, we're also long the IWM. It's at 221.57, up 327. It's actually up 1.5%. I like that. It's broken the resistance level. It's just nicked the 14-period exponential moving average. Wow, it's going to take a lot for the 9 to cross from pink to green over the black 14-period moving average. The MACD is struggling. The stochastic's only at 21%. It's got a lot of catching up to do in the IWM. Let's just do this real quickly. I want to finish up here with gold. Actually, I can't do that quickly because I've got at least a couple of questions on gold. Then I mustn't forget there was a question in the dinner about platinum. So let me just put this in my notebook right here so I can go in order. So gold, let's just do that. Platinum, PL, a question about the IYT, question about, where was it? Oh, Moderna, mRNA, question about... Where did it go? Where did it go? A question about BSX. That's very. I haven't looked at that in years. We had a spectacular gain on BSX, Boston Scientific, years ago, both on the short side and the long side. Haven't even done anything with it for years. Okay, so gold. The pattern that I'm looking at here. Well, first of all, for the people who did my webinar a week ago today. Yes, thank you for sending in the charts. Some of you really picked up a lot. Now, the one thing I said yesterday, and for those of you who did my course, you know exactly what I meant. Look what happened yesterday at this time when I was talking about the 10-minute chart. Where's the 10-minute chart? Of the S&P E-mini. I said, look, it's crossing positive, and it looks very good. And there it is. And it ran all the way in green, all the way up. Well, hi. We'll be back. That's what Chapman Tiger Nation's Hour.
Are you looking for a way to consistently add winning trades to your portfolio? Tom O'Brien is here to help. Tom O'Brien has been successfully trading markets for over 30 years. A frequent contributor to TD Ameritrade Network and CNBC, Tom O'Brien founded TFNN over 20 years ago to help educate investors just like you. Tom's daily market newsletter, Market Insights, is published every morning when the markets open to give you the competitive informational edge you need to succeed. These newsletters are packed full of Tom's advanced technical analysis and are geared to deliver comprehensive strategies for a successful portfolio. Get Tom O'Brien's newsletter, Market Insights, today and try all of our products and newsletters 30 days risk-free with our money-back guarantee at TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right, information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TESS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TASS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE. And you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern, for free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Hi, folks. So we're back. Dow's up 281, S251, S&P's up 23. So this is what I was talking about yesterday. I said, look, all those things that we discussed in the webinar, everything's in place, and you've got a nice liftoff in the E-mini. And look what happened. It stayed all the way to the peak D. D's are what we look at all the time. Look at today's action. We went peak A, B, C, D once, and then we went E, F, G, sharp pullback at 4 o'clock this morning. Pulls back and then starts a brand new buy, and it goes so far. I am going to call this a leg B. Technically, it could be an alternate count, but there's no need to do that. Just calling it a B for now. And what I had drawn in a little earlier is I think this is a different pattern today entirely. I've got a feeling that we will close quite a bit off the low, if I'm correct. But in the meantime, look, the two-minute chart went to a peak F. Remember, peak F is where you've got to be really careful. There it is, turning down. So all those techniques that we discussed, everything we discussed is right here in front of you. Even that one, look at this right here. I'm going to draw this in for those of you who took the course right here. Look at the clues that you can see as we start to turn down. So just keep in mind, Wednesday week, we're going to do the second part of the two-part webinar. First part is archived. Just for your perusal to go over and over and over as many times as you want. Second one will be in a week's time. So I'm going to go back to the questions coming up in a moment. Gold is coming back a little bit. It's down 6 only at 1804. It went down to 1794. I mean, 10 points lower for a little double bottom there. This is going to be very important to see how it plays out. So a couple of questions. So trust you are well. Interested to get your updated view on gold, please. And yesterday's show, you mentioned gold was in play. Let me just explain what I mean by in play. In play means, for me, that there are trades up and down and sideways. It's not just moribund going sideways and nothing to see here. But the reason why I said it was in play is because I think that the Bitcoin, the people who are trading, not the people who just buy and hold Bitcoin, the people who are trading Bitcoin are constantly looking for the kind of action that gold very often has. And it hasn't for a little while, but it's enough to consider even intraday there's a play. That's what I mean by in play. But what I have said is that the GDX failing like this, this is the gold miners ETF, just making lower lows and lower highs, in arch formation, and you showed me a chart. You've done a great job of analysis in your XAU. This is the gold. This is the gold and silver sector. This is the index. And look at this, a little pop today, up a dollar at 136.21. But absolutely, you were correct. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Let me just get out of there. So in the arch formation, you drew the arch. There are a whole bunch of things we could do. I'm not going to take the time now to do it, other than to say, if I use this as a plumb line right here. Now, remember when I discussed plumb lines, I said I like very much if you can go to the top or the bottom and just by eye, as you're looking at it, say, you know what, if we pull back, we could make an arch formation with a left side price, left side, right side price time match. Look at this. If I go from there, and you don't have to have the rectangle or anything, you could just use a straight line. You could even do it on paper. It's just not a big deal. Just what we're doing is we're going from the left side to the right side. I'll put this in over here, not knowing what's going on the right. I'll make this green because it's on the way up. This is the XAU trading at 136.18, up $1.05. And let's see what happens. And then what I like to do is to say, let's take, I showed you exactly how I do it. Let's take a trend line, Chapman wave inside wedge, propellant. Whoops, no, let me just do this. Talking and waving your hands at the same time. A Chapman wave inside wedge target support or target resistance line. On the way down, it goes pink, and I change it to a dash. Most of you can change to dashed or straight line or whatever it is. So that's what I just do for my own. And I always stick to the same thing. And look, it came down and went right to that level, and it stalled right there at the low of the 30th of April at 142.01 for a moment. And then it made the dreaded H. It went lower, made another H, and went lower. And another H, this is the lowercase h that goes to lowercase m, and now it's gone to a low of 132.83. So you've done a really good analysis. Now, you know what I like to do? I like to take a trend line, and it's just a trend line to say, hey, these two levels, if you get two points of activity, of touch, that means it's a legitimate line that says if you break under it, it can go much, much lower. But if it holds, that's good. So right here, you've got a green line that's, a red line. And then I'm going to put the green line in. All of these just really easy techniques to use. Right here, green line, right there. And you've got the Chapman wave inside track, propellant or support level. If it takes it out, it's in trouble. So right here is where the XAU, and I'm even going to just have a quick look at the GDX, which has done not quite the same thing. You see, the trend line here would have gone to a much lower low, and it hasn't. So in a way, that's good. But it has also got a second one that's there. So all I'm saying is that the GDX, yes, it might be ready for a little bit of a bounce, but I think as long as the dollar is holding its strength, it's not quite that relationship, but it's close. 32 is really important support. A close under 32, and the GDX says, no, it's a problem. Let me finish now what you were saying. I was doing some Chapman wave work on the golds, and on a 50-minute chart, there was a nice channel formation culminating in wave E. Then gold broke down, $20, and the price this morning is still below the channel. It appears there is an arch formation in play on the 15-minute. Zooming out on a bigger time frame, 4 hours or even a daily, it could be a beginning of the dreaded H pattern. Interested to know your views. Below 1795 should confirm it. P.S. again, Chapman wave channel and wave Chapman wave count, along with another entry technique, gave me the confidence to take a short position yesterday for a day trade. PSSS. If you get a chance, please do a review. Two people have asked about Tesla, so I'll get to that. Okay. So, yeah, I see you're doing the homework, and I think that as long as you keep doing your analysis, when it breaks on the upside, all your resistance levels, finally you're going to get a bit more of a bounce. But treat gold as being in play as a tradable. This is the gold itself, because if you look at silver, silver's been saying, gold? What are you talking about? I have no relationship to gold. Look at me. I'm just way. Yeah, they are related, but silver's much weaker than gold. It's broken in the inverted falling X formation. I'd say it's getting ready for a little bit of a bounce, and that might correspond to the dollar, which we are long since April of 2018. at 90.07, dollars at 92.91. Yeah, it's getting a little bit tired. Gold, dollar could have a little bit of a pullback. That might help gold. But I think that the dollar at this particular point, still the weekly chart is still strong enough in this cup. It's a V-shaped formation already in leg C, on the one way down. So I discussed this in my webinar, how severe a leg A to the downside is on the downside, how it can spring to the upside. We've just seen that. Look at this. We've just seen that in the Dow, INDU. Look at this. Huge move, single leg A, and look at this whopper of a move, and it's still right at the trend line over there. So yes, keep doing your work, your homework there. Let me go to Tesla because I have other calls as well. TSLA. Tesla's kind of stuck. It's done the H, inverted H. It's like a V-shape, an inverted V-shape formation. Dreaded H. It held okay on the left side. It's trying to rally. I think it's just stuck for now. I think at 661.97, I'd say I'll be back in a moment. All right?
Are you having fun trading the markets but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, everyone. So look, here we are. This is the two-minute chart. Remember, rectangle formation can last a lot longer than your patience. When it makes the dreaded H pattern, watch the left side, a low. And right now at 43.35 on the E-mini, it's only up 19 points after the massive move yesterday. You're starting to see some deterioration after that peak F top in the two-minute chart. I'll be back right here to show you the, yep, there it is. So Tesla, I'm just going to put this rectangle in for now. I think the upside is kind of limited just right at this moment. So I'm saying 676 maybe on the upside. But if it takes out 643, on the downside. It's at 658 right now. Anytime in the next few days, I think that makes another lowercase H pattern, and that's the test of 620 coming up. So I right now, it's at just down $1.30. Next question was, so I don't see anything much on the upside. I think it's stuck in a range right now. Myrna made a peak D if there's no new recovery high. Yesterday, 241.51 was high. I thought I talked about this yesterday. I said it made a round number 292.00 open. If the price, that 292 now has to be support. If at any point it closes under 292, it says in the short term, the daily chart is making some kind of a sell signal. Maybe it could go to a sell mode, but the technicals are still too strong to even talk about that. So that's what I'm watching. And it says that the 307 was the high. I'd say 309 to 311 is kind of resistance right now, holding very well off the spectacular leg, D to the upside, D in the daily and D in the weekly chart. I'm watching this closely. So yes, the question was on Myrna, Moderna trading at 300.42 mRNA, down almost 7 points. I think it's just consolidating, a fantastic move. It's a fantastic company. I want someone to give me a yell if this gets to 268 to 262 at any time in the next 2 weeks. That's where I want to look at it to say, is that perhaps a new buying opportunity? But at this point, it's acting very well. Next question was ASX. ASX is ASE, Industrial Holding Company, W/1I or something. I don't know what that means. Yeah. So, I didn't do any work on this. So what is the question? Holding Company. Thank you, Steve. So can you give your expert take on this company, symbol ASX? Ha-ha. Expert, now we're in trouble. All right, let's do this. First of all, just on a visual basis, as my people do, the attendees to my webinar last week, I'm going to be doing a lot more of this coming week. Just saying, what do you see? What immediate can you grab? I grab the cup formation, and then I go from the low here and say, well, the MACD cross positive, stochastic cross positive, I'm going to give this a buy, an up signal, an up arrow, meaning it's in a buy mode because it's already gone peak A, peak B, and today it's extended leg C, and that is just, wow, look at that. The left side high was on the 14th of June, $8. I just looked at the price, only $8, $8.78. Today's high is $8.72. So I suspect it's going to go above. When it goes above, that's going to be the big question, because you've got the rectangle formation in the, right here. Rectangle formation in the weekly chart. Look at that. And it's the lopsided gravy cup. Well, not so lopsided. It's almost equal. So let's do this. And you've got the cup formation right here. So it's in bars. I think it's probably getting close. So there's a good chance this is going to be new leg A, gray leg A. Oh, I meant to show that earlier on. Or I'll do that tomorrow. I'll treat tomorrow as Chapman Wave Friday, where we go into more detail in the technical analysis. I'm not going to be here Friday. I haven't been able to work out whether I can do an early show, pre-recorded, or I'm just not here at all. So for subscribers, Saturday, I won't be doing the overview. I'll be doing it Sunday when I'm back. So let's just have a look at this. Yes. So the question is, do I like it? Yes, I like it very much. Do I like it in context to the relative strength as it relates to the market itself? I like it very much. What it does, I don't know. You didn't say if you're long or short. I like it if you were going to get in now. The trouble is you've got 70, 30-something cents to the high of 678. No, it's only 21 cents. So that's a bit of a risk because it could go there. This is, remember, I should still call this gray, even though it's a buy mode. I have confidence to say I'm pretty sure this is a brand new buy mode that should go to a D, but it could stall right here and then make it just a nominal new high, a fraction right on in the rectangle formation, in this case, right at or just below or just above the previous high and then stall. So this is what I'm going to recommend. Steve, why, if you don't have it, if you have it, I'm going to say don't do anything. Hold it. It's acting really well, number one. Number two is if you are looking to enter it, I'm going to say start your position right now, realizing that it could pull back 40 cents. I mean, percentage-wise, that's 5%. Give it, you got to give it a little bit of room. I like it, so I'm saying ASX. I'm even writing that down. Yes, at 868. And that's your, I wouldn't get the full position. This is your, like, your starter position, right? And then just look at it again next week, Tuesday or Wednesday. I like it, and I love the fact that it's the monthly chart. I started a new move, peak A, now it's B, and that will start leg C if it goes one penny above $8.78. $8.79 starts leg C in the monthly, and that means that the weekly chart, I'm going to have to say that's probably a leg B, a brand new leg B. I like it very much. I don't know what they do, but whatever they do, acting very well in this market environment. So next question was platinum. You see, the pattern that we spoke about for a little while now, and I've demonstrated it, right there. So this is the Chapman Wave falling X formation. Rally, 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 stall, make lower highs and much lower lows, suddenly find support, breaks the downtrend line, goes in Chapman Wave one-to-one to the upside, which can test the left side high. Well, wait a minute. That's very interesting, because this looks like this could be the upside down one. Well, lo and behold, there it is. So now you come down sharply, you make higher highs. The rule of thumb is if it actually can go to, instead of fading at a peak A or a B for like a dreaded H pattern, the lowercase H pattern with the arch formation, this has gone all the way to a D. It could rally, break under the key support level, and then hang around here for a little bit. It doesn't have to go all the way down to the low in the continuous contract of platinum, down to 1023.80 that was on the 21st of June. Somewhere in this area could find some support. So your next support level is at 1049.10. That's the low of the 30th of June. And somewhere in between there should find enough support from now until then. There should be enough support at some point to try to test both the 9 and 14 period moving averages at about 1,089 and the uptrend resistance line. It was support, now it's resistance. Once it goes to a D, you've used up upside energy, but you've also used downside weakness so that it comes back, but it really comes back in a big consolidation. Look, I drew this in a long time ago, the 1-to-1, A to B equals C to D. This is almost like a Chapman wave. A breakout pattern of the in this case it's a flag, a channel comes down to, and it's gone a little bit more. So platinum isn't quite ready yet for a bigger move, but I am going to say that it is in play for trying to make a bottom above 1050 to 1045. But I wouldn't do anything. I'll be back in a moment, Amber. We're looking at the doubt.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at tfnn.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with a 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
So we're just going to have a quick look at Baidu. It's up $1.22. Remember yesterday I said it's making that H pattern. If it holds the left side low, it can bounce. If it's able to bounce above 180, it's a big, big ask. But if it's able to go... a close above 188.50. A close above that says, okay, downside is now complete, at least for the moment, and it should have a rally to try to fill the gap in the 190s. At this point, this is still early. It's just filled in the latest gap of 4 days ago. 181 is going to be resistance at this particular point. I think the weekly says it's still a very weak stock. A BSX question. BS, where did that go? Well, I wouldn't have got it. I looked at this on Sunday night. And look at this. Plummets down. He has your rectangle formation, just so many rectangle formations, rule of thumb of the rectangle formation. Once you start to make higher highs and higher lows, you can go in a shorter time frame to at least a D. It did that. And you can also have an arch formation, which says you've got to retest the low if it goes there very quickly to A or B, which it did. And now it's very strong bounce. I like Boston Scientific. It's acting really well. Right now it's going to the Chapman wave inside track. Let's just draw this for you. Another lesson, live lesson, just like we did the other day, all day, drew these things in, new parallel, this is the resistance, it's just above it, cannot hold into the close today, that's going to be important. If a Boston Scientific gets to 44.20, there's a real good chance very quickly it's going to test the previous high on the 25th of June of 44.27, and if it does that, then the 44.63 high of the week of the 30th of April becomes viable. So far it's acting very well, and wow, it gets to the 45s and you're in leg C in the monthly chart. Very, very good action. The last 2 days it was terrible in the 41 area. Now it's wonderful in the 43.50s. So just treat it, use your technical analysis. There's the dreaded H failure, and there's that reversal of the huge Chapman wave falling X. Lower highs, much lower lows, turns around, finds support, and then it breaks the resistance band. That's what we're going to be watching for. PDD, I always forget what. Isn't this the Duo or something? Yep, Pinduoduo. Not as good a chart at all. So I wouldn't say Baidu was a good chart, but this is a lousy-looking chart. You've got it 103.85, up $1.60. PDD, Pinduoduo, this is, it's just asking a lot for it to do anything but have a little bit of a bounce. But if there's more than a bounce, if it can go from 133 by Friday a week, by this coming Friday a week, if it's able to even touch 110.50, it says finally, it's finally enough support to say that it's going to have a more intermediate term rally. That's the way I'm looking at it. It kind of goes for Baidu as well. Where was it? Next question is, hi, Basil, could you please look at AVXL? AVXL, that sounds familiar. Have I ever looked at this? No, I haven't. Anavis Life Sciences Core. I saw a stock that looked just like this earlier today. Did I write? And I probably forgot to write down. So what I immediately do is I go to a conservative way of trend lining. So what I do is AVXL has a high recently of 20 on the 28th of June of 31.50. It comes down sharply, tries to rally, fails, makes a peak B minus in a dreaded H pattern, takes out the left side low. So it's simply put, it's making lower lows and lower highs. Right here is really simple. The MACD is weak. The stochastic is finding some support at 9.73. That's not strong, but it's finding some support. On balance, volume is still pretty good. And the relative strength at about 49% is actually quite good. So I am looking at this. I don't know. It looks to me almost like life science. Oh, I was going to say it looks like a biotech stock of your life sciences. It probably is. So all I can say is it has this rhythm of 1, 2, 3, 4, bam, 1, 2, 3, 4, bam. So it has this rhythm that it's just lost, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it didn't have the bam. It did pop. So now it's running out of upside energy. So I know if the question is, if you're long, oh, no chart seen? What are you talking about, no chart seen? I can see the charts, can't I? Have I lost my charts? I have. How did that happen? Oh, man, that's not good. How long has that been? I actually closed everything down and refreshed. I can't see where I lost it. Lost your chart. Oh, all that work, and I've lost the chart. I have to just discuss all of those things again. So let me just do this real quickly. I don't know where we lost it. ASX, I don't know if I lost it there. Look, ASX has got the cup formation. It's trying to break out. You heard what I said, and all of that applies. Whatever this one is, this is AVXL. That's the one we're coming to right now. But let me just finish the other one. I did PDD, DODO. This one, remember, dreaded H, and it makes a lower thing. It's going to take a lot for it to really turn and hold. Has to get to the 110, 111 area. Baidu is the same thing. This is a quick review for those because I lost my charts. This is the dreaded H. So far, it's successful in Baidu and it's trying to rally. It's filled in one gap. It's got a lot of work to do. And the only way I could say that this looks very good is if it could start to trade in the 188 area. And now let's go to your question was AVXL. That was a nice quick wrap up. AVXL was like a lightning round. So AVXL makes a high right there around about the 28th, I think it was. Yeah, 28th of June of 31.50. Pulls back to the low of the last 2 days, which is in the 20.28, 20.27 area. A little bit of a rally today of 79 cents. For this, and it's in a sell mode. The MACD is lousy, stochastics at 9.73%. But the weekly chart is saying it has this rhythm that says it keeps popping to the upside. Well, it's lost that rhythm. It's got more of the rhythm to the downside. I think this is a story stock. So I would do this. If it starts, you have to do it intraday because after that, it's too late. If this rallies above 23.37 on any single day, can't do it slowly. It's got to do it in one day. Grab it. In fact, grab it if it gets to 23.25 and put in a tight stop and just run with it. And you even have to probably get out at the end of the day because it doesn't last for more than a day and then it pulls back. Or raise the stop enough to say, I've got a profit on one position. I'm taking a little bit off so that I can lock that position in. And now I'm raising the stop in my core position and just let it go. That's the only way I would do it. So AVXL, it's kind of run out of upside energy. It's now downside energy that it has to overcome. So if it closes under 19.50, I wouldn't be looking at this. Give me a yell and we'll look at it again in about a week's time. So the next question is NVIDIA. So I haven't redone NVIDIA. That means I have to do all my daily charts, my weekly charts, and my monthly charts. Because remember, I have it right here as pre-split. You can see all my notation. This is peak A, then with B, C, D, and it had it. Look, A, B, C, D. It's in leg E to the upside. Okay, we got one segment to go. It's in leg E to the upside, NVIDIA, and today is trading You see, this is what I'm a little concerned about right here, is that this is such a selective rally that the CLF, let me just do this before I come back to the video. CLF, we discussed it in great detail the other day. I said, yeah, I would start a little nibble on it and then add it to rallies. Where is the 20.17 earnings coming out tomorrow?
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Markets can rise and fall like the tides. Subscribe to Basil Chapman's newsletter, The Opening Call, and you too can ride the wave. Basil Chapman is an authority in technical analysis. His Chapman Wave trading system has been helping traders identify trends and capitalize on momentum in the markets since 1984. TFNN invites you to test Basil's proprietary Chapman Wave trading methodology with a monthly subscription to the Opening Call newsletter for only $149. Your subscription to the Opening Call comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, as well as daily market updates on key indexes, stocks, and commodities. Ride the wave! Sign up for the Opening Call risk-free today.
Introducing Primal Edge.
Today, it's even more important to take a supplement that complements your health. Primal Edge is specifically formulated to boost your immune system and help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Our early ancestors found all their nutritional requirements in the wild environment. But today, our food sources don't contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients that we need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated humic and fulvic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, without them, life cannot exist.
That's right, Ellen. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, just $89, exclusively at TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. We're back, and we're going to go straight to Earl. Earl, how are you?
Good morning, Basil. How are you? I'm doing fine.
Good. So you'd like to look at SLV. That's the Silver iShares Trust.
Yeah, that's right. I'm in it, but I'm looking for an entry for more.
So now you're in it, and this is probably a longer-term position that you're trying to place. Is that correct?
That is correct.
So if I was doing this in one-thirds, if you're already in, right here at 2331 is probably where I would say I would give it maybe a day. Because if it pops above the gap down high of the 19th, which is 23.51, which is only 20 cents, just more than 20 cents above, then I would say I'd get my second third, but I'd wait for the final third quite a bit later. I'd even wait until it maybe even touches 22. But in the meantime, I'd give it a day. I wouldn't say get in now, because if in the next 2 days it doesn't do that, but instead it takes out 23, round number low of yesterday, that kind of makes it vulnerable, and that it even means that it's testing the monthly 14-period exponential moving average. I don't see anything really bad about SLV right now. It's just that it's a weak play. Silver's much weaker. I like to see silver actually start to move stronger than gold, and it's not doing that. So I'm going to suggest, at least in my work, I would hold off. I'd maybe just add a little. I wouldn't get carried away, because I think it's going to take time for really to explode to the upside, maybe another week or two. But maybe add a little bit over 23.52, maybe a little bit. But I would be careful. That's all I'm going to say to you. I just don't have enough conviction in silver at this point. Hope that helps you.
Thank you, Basil. You're the best.
Well, thank you very much. We'll see next week what happens. So, folks, stay tuned. We've got great programming coming up. Check out my opening call newsletter. And also, don't forget, a week from today is the next two-hour live performance, so the performance it is, of my two-day webinar. Have a great day.